We had another cold front, very legit thing that just blew through last night, and winds are out of the north, so I am thinking live bait at the jetty. We're gonna get this spinning setup right here, rigged and ready to go. Hang in there, and we'll be right on the water.
Water's so still, and my pain's gone away. The air is much cleaner after it rains. Follow my love, except it's in spring air. Follow the moment of the sun. There's a call for new beginnings here. Let the sorrow of yesterday disappear. Let your body be new.
We got a bird fight.
These guys are... Oh my gosh, that wind is howling. Ain't nobody on the jetty, and it's for good reason. Cold front, high winds. But that's coming from, there's no way that's the northeast. We're here, we've already got the bait. Let's enjoy ourselves. It's not really that cold. I'm just putting on my rain jacket because the swells are really crashing over the rocks. In case y'all were wondering, like, dude is preparing for Armageddon. Nah, it ain't that. What we're going for is a number two circle hook right there. And then I'm gonna use a swivel, not a swivel. Well, yes, a swivel, but also a little egg sinker. 30 pound monofilament line right there. Six inches of leader line right there so that our mullet can, as we cast, the mullet will be about that far away from the egg sinker. And then once it gets down there, the mullet can go ahead and take off if he wants to. All right, fellas, who wants to go first? We've got a combination of finger mullet and mud minnows today. That's a lively little fella. Oh my gosh, that took forever for it to get down to the bottom. I hope I don't get snagged. Uh-oh. We already got hit. Okay, let's fix that up. Oh yeah, somebody already hit him. Goodness gracious. Come on, baby, let's just get a bite. This little guy was getting a little bit nervous. Come on. There we go. There we go. Come on. There we go. That's what we want to see. You little guy. How is it that you can fit a mullet that big in there? Chill out, buddy. Chill out. You could barely get that mullet around your mouth. You little glutton. There we are. That's a small little tater skin right there. It's a good start to the day, though. That tide has come in and it's pushing like really strong. I just took a look at the tide app and we've got a lot of water volume coming in a very short period of time. It was dead low whenever I first got out here and it's only been a few hours and we're almost gonna be at high in another hour. So that just kind of shows you what's going on. I'm gonna check my bait because it's been out there for a long time. Oh yeah, he's lively. I did walk down that way on the jetty, but it's very, if you just take a look at it, maybe I'll pull the iPhone out to get a little bit more depth perception. Goodness gracious, man. You have a death wish if you want to go out there and try to withstand all of that garbage. Not for no bites. I mean, if we were getting the bite, then yeah, maybe I might do it for YouTube. But I mean, look at this. It brings to mind a story that happened to me whenever I was a kid fishing this jetty. And it was the same exact one too, because I mean, I just remember it vividly. Something like that gets seared into your brain. My dad brought my older brother and myself out, and we were fishing, didn't know any better. I mean, we were just young kids. Next thing you know, a big old huge swell comes over, pushes my tackle box over. I lose my rod. I also got swept over. Next thing you know, I'm screaming for my brother as I'm on this side, and he holds his rod down. I grab it and then grab his hand, and he pulls me up to safety. So that's just kind of something that, I don't know, it'll never leave you. And it makes you think twice about trying to go all the way down there where I want to go. But yeah, you definitely think twice. All right, we're gonna move really fast. We just had a swell come over and like really do a number. Hang out right here. All right, Spidey, watch that for me, please. All right, I think we got something. Oh man, we don't got nothing. I don't know if we're stuck down there because of all the water being flushed out. Yeah, we got him. Dude, if this guy is the same one, I'm gonna poop. Okay, I don't see any hook marks. But he is cookie cutter size from the other one that we just got. Uh-oh, sorry, buddy. All right. Well, that's, at least they're keeping us busy. Look at this mud minnow. Whoa. Dude, they are so slippery. They're freaking slimy little suckers. I'm pretty sure that didn't feel too good, buddy. Boy, they are lively. Like, that dude is super lively. I may start buying these guys. Okay, I think we got something. All right, buddy. Show us what we want to see. Yeah, I think we got him. No! Okay, we still have our minnow. Oh my gosh. I am so sorry. Look at that. Wow, that's the thumbnail, right? That should be the thumbnail. Poor fella is he's still alive. I feel so bad. Dude, I honestly, I'm just gonna try to let you die in peace, buddy. Boy, wow. I guess them flounder have gotta eat their Wheaties, huh? If it's those little fellas. Man, I should have let him hold it for a little bit longer, so that the hook would have gotten his mouth. I swear, if you got away, buddy, I'm gonna be so upset. Oh my gosh, stupid mud minnow. Fresh mud minnow, come on, man. Somebody, quit making us wait. I'll wait, though. And I think this is gonna be my last cast. Sun is setting. I gave it my best. But man, oh man, what a very tough day. I honestly thought we were gonna do a lot better than this. Go, guys. Mud minnow, super slippery, fellas. We got all kinds of stuff in here. Mud minnows, finger mullet. I don't know what this is. Y'all tell me, is that a mud minnow? Look like a snakehead. Whatever he is, he's pretty dang ugly. Dude, y'all better go. These seagulls are just freaking looking at y'all. I don't know why they just don't want to leave. Uh-oh. Well, That made things easy. Let's get out of here. I'm not too sure, but this one right here, that third reef pasta, crab, shrimp, and scallops, and a light butter sauce. And then the one that you liked was the
stuffed flounder.
It's got the like crawfish cream sauce or something like that.
Yeah, right, that's exactly what it is.
Topped with a roasted red bell pepper and crawfish cream sauce. I know what y'all were thinking, that I probably caught a flounder and kept it. No, not this guy. Thank you.
You can't really mess that up.
Thank you. Thank you.
You made some decisions on your
That right there is buffalo popcorn shrimp, is what I would call it. I forgot. He called it like baked shrimp. But this right here, y'all. It's called baked shrimp.
I'm gonna look it up. Oh, baked shrimp, yeah.
Yeah. Super good. I just did it right now. Thank you so much. It came just in time too, because I'm almost done. I'm gonna pick it up. Sorry, y'all, I'm doing a horrible YouTube job. Too busy stuffing my space with that shrimp, and we're almost done with that, but check this out. Right there, we've got a linguine pasta and a buttercream sauce, some grilled shrimp, grilled scallops, and over here, the wife got stuffed flounder. That does look spectacular. All right, everyone, thank you so much for tagging along on today's adventure. I'm definitely gonna enjoy this meal right here. It's just what the doctor ordered, and I wish that the fishing could have been just a little bit better, but you know, sometimes that's just the way that it always goes, and you can't always make the fish bite. I am grateful for those two little flounder, and we are gonna enjoy some flounders. So again, thank you so much. If you enjoyed it, click that thumbs up button. For those of y'all interested in everything that we were using today, that's gonna be linked in the video description down below. And until next time, tight lines, y'all.
Slow dancing with